Now, this drove me crazy. So you're making a moral equivalency, and Chris Wallace is doing this. Biden does it all day long, and so does every liberal Democrat in the world, between far-right white supremacists and the Antifa, Black Lives Matter demonstrators. It's the same in their mind. The destruction's the same. The threat is the same. It's mind-boggling. Roll the tape.
Have you ever called the Democratic mayor of Portland or the Democratic governor of Oregon and said, hey, you got to stop this, bring in the National Guard, do whatever it takes, but you stop the days and months of violence in Portland?
I don't hold public office now. I am a former vice president. I've made it clear. I've made it clear in my public statements that the violence should be prosecuted. It should be prosecuted. And anyone who commits it should be
prosecuted. But you've never called for the people, the leader, excuse me, sir. You had never called for the leaders in Portland and in Oregon to call and bring in the National Guard and knock off 100 days of riots.
They can, in fact, take care of it if he just stay out of the way.
Are you kidding me? They can take care of it? It's going on 110 days. Last night, two officers were severely injured by Molotov cocktails. All of the violence is generated by Antifa and the far left kooks. The Proud Boys show up in counter demonstrations. We did some research on the Proud Boys, and I'll give it to you in a minute, because it's just insane. This whole thing is insane on what they're doing. Okay? So then Wallace turns to Donald Trump and brings up the far right. Roll it.
Well, I would say almost everything I see is from the left wing, not from the right wing.
So what are you saying?
I'm willing to do anything. I want to see peace.
Then do it, sir.
Say it.
Do you want to call them? What do you want to call them? Give me a name.
White supremacists and
white supremacists. Who would you like me to condemn?
White supremacists and right
wing. Proud Boys, stand back and stand by.
What does that mean? Stand back and stand by. I don't know what that means. Why would you say it? All you got to say is, look, I don't want the Proud Boys or any other group causing violence. That's it. All right, the Proud Boys. This is such a... So I asked my best investigators to look into it, okay? What we found out is there are hundreds of Proud Boys, but not 800. There may be 300. We don't know. They don't give out their membership, but there's never been a crowd of Proud Boys more than 300. Anywhere, ever. There are tens of thousands of far-left demonstrators. There have been less than 10 arrests in 3 years of Proud Boys. Less than 10. There have been literally 10,000 arrests of far-left groups for looting and burning down and killing cops and you name it. And this is an equivalency? This is what CNN and NBC News and, oh, that Proud Boy. What in it? This is the gross dishonesty of the country in which we live.
Bill O'Reilly is back on TV and only on the 1st. No Spin News. Every weeknight at 8 p.m. Eastern, only on the 1st.